Hey everyone, it's a short video to show you all the different mutes you can have on a violin or a viola. So we start with this little one there, which is made out of rubber. This is mostly like a concert mute. It doesn't really mute the sound, it just like slightly muffle it. So that's roughly the volume without the mute. And now if you put the mute, which you can clip on one of the string and then clip it on the bridge like that, you have a slightly less powerful sound. Slightly warmer sound. The volume is still there. So it's good for just like a concert gig. Next one. So this is like the heavier mutes, which are say for practice mute. I'll go from the worst to the best one. So this one is the Ultra USA. It's made out of rubber as well. It's slightly more flexible. It's larger, way larger. This one is specifically designed for viola, so it fits my bridge perfectly. You just have to slightly, you know, clip it on it, and then it fits nicely on the bridge. It's like looks properly designed for it. But then the sound is very muffled, and on the low end it's pretty horrendous. So this is not exactly the best mute I've ever played with. It gives the a nice warm tone, but the low end is not very muted. It cuts the high end and even like vibrate even more on the low end, which is why I don't even use it. Next one is this weird little chap, which is like brass with three prongs, which you fit in the middle, and it doesn't really fit nicely on the bridge. It's slightly awkward and tilting. See, it doesn't, and I don't really want to push it too much because it's in brass, it's going to imprint the wood of the bridge. So let's see how it sounds like. Still slightly, you know, nasal sound, mutes a bit, it just doesn't fit, you know, it doesn't really sit properly on the bridge. Next one is the one I've been using for a very long time. It's made out of lead, I believe it's designed for violin directly, so it doesn't entirely fit nicely on the bridge. It's kind of, you know, you can see the openings where the bridge fits in, so it's fixed. So I don't know, the shape of my bridge doesn't fit, or if it's not standard, but it doesn't fit up to the end, to the end of it. Sounds like, you know, looks like it's designed more for violin because it doesn't fit up to the end. That particular bridge actually was done by a luthier, a violin maker in France, and I show him that mute, so he made his best to fit, but obviously you don't want to compromise the sound too much. So this is the best fit I have, the best fit I can have. It works well, I'm quite happy with it, but the problem you have is when you play some time on the C string, it will start vibrating and jump, and it will jump out. So it's very good for practice mute, like if you play in a flat, because it mutes the sound very well. So as you can see, if you attack the C string too much, it will just jump and land on the flooring, which is good and not very nice. Oh well. Next one. And the last one, which is the one I'm using currently, Same principle, it's made out of rubber but it's slightly better design. It's covered, so it's in lead but covered in rubber, and on top you have two screws there. I think they do models with an hexagonal screw, which is easier to unscrew. That one has triangular keys, and I have the bits for the screwdriver coming this weekend, so you can change the opening there for the bridge, and hopefully it will sit a bit more nicely on the bridge. Because it has rubber, it's less prone to jumping out, and it fits quite nicely on it. Obviously it doesn't fit up to the end because, as usual, it's for violin and not exactly for viola, so you know, it's not going up to the end. But the sound is almost like the same, the frequency response is quite flat in my opinion, and it doesn't jump. So there you go, a short introduction of all the mutes you can have on a viola. There are other mutes existing. Leather one, for instance, would give you quite fuzzy, warm sound, and it fits like the same principle than the brass one, with like some prongs which you fit on it. I haven't got it here because it was not what I was after, but if you want a slightly different sound on your viola, might be something you want to look at or recommend. The one I would recommend, if anything, if you play like me in a flat with lovely neighbors, that one, lead with rubber around it, avoid it jumping and denting your flooring. Alright, hope you enjoyed the video, guys. Bye.